So today is going to be a little bit of a special day. And the reason it's going to be a special day is that I'm going to make a video about my 1 year on YouTube. That is right, 1 year on YouTube. So today we're going to talk about 1 year on YouTube and what's the experience like. Before I got on YouTube, I really didn't like these social medias. I mean, I like them to hang out a little bit, check out some content, watch some cool videos, but I didn't feel a need to be present on there. When I was a professional kitesurfer, I felt the need because it was a way for me to communicate, to build my image, to build my personal brand. But the moment I stopped kitesurfing and started playing poker, I was going more inwards and I valued it more to be anonymous, and I didn't need my message to be out there. I didn't need to speak my opinion to people. So what changed? What's the reason that I actually decided to start out and build a YouTube channel, put my face out there and share my story with the world and share my opinion, share my thoughts and try to help, educate, share, build connections through something like YouTube? Well, in 2016, I turned vegan, April to be exact. And it got me so frustrated, and I'm the type of person that either does something 300% or doesn't do it at all. And when I turned vegan, I was like, I have to do something about this. For me, this is outrageous with all the things that are happening. If you don't know anything about this and you have Netflix, check out Cowspiracy, check out What the Health. There's many more things. If you want to know more, just leave a comment down below and I'll provide you with some more information about this. But to cut things short, I wanted to become an activist. I wanted to share and raise awareness among people. So I decided to open up a YouTube channel. And I don't like this negative, in-your-face pushing type of activism where people say, meat is murder, you shouldn't do this, you shouldn't do that. Because I believe that we come from thousands of years of evolution where we are used culturally to do that, and I know not a lot of people are that comfortable stepping out of their comfort zone and changing their habits. I mean, it's really, really difficult. I noticed it for myself as well, starting as an entrepreneur. Changing your habits takes time. It's a process. It's about planting seeds. It's about pushing forward and doing all these things. So I decided to start a vegan food channel because I'm an amazing chef. Not really at all. I know how to cook and I thought I was passionate about food, but turns out I just enjoy eating nice food. That's it. Like, I'm not passionate about filming it and obsessively creating content around that. So I quickly noticed that that was not my thing, and I wanted to do something more that actually raised awareness rather than provide an opportunity or a different solution on how to cook something. So I became an activist. And I thought that it was very important for me to share this message and raise awareness, because it all starts with raising awareness, becoming conscious of something. When you want to change a habit, the first thing you need to do is acknowledge that you have a habit. Just like a drug addict or an alcoholic, you need to acknowledge that you are an alcoholic before you can change it. And I thought that me going out and my ability to talk very easily to people, to empathize with other people and put myself in their shoes and talk with them from a different perspective could definitely help a lot. So I went out on the street in Zwolle for the first time. I don't know when, it's about a year ago as well. And I did some interviews with people on the street. I was super scared. It was way out of my comfort zone, but I did it. And once I did it, I started to enjoy it and I started to do it more and more and more, and people liked the videos that they were seeing. So it's like validation that the thing you're doing is actually worth something to some group of people. However, being an activist on the street is very limiting, because you only influence the people you actually talk to right that second. There's no follow-up. You don't know anything about if they're gonna do something with the information you actually told them. And the entertainment you create on the internet is only there for vegans to watch. And I mean,
a normal person is probably never gonna look for these type of videos. So I was kind of being a vegan entertainer, and I didn't like that. I wanna create solutions, and that's where entrepreneurship started to play a role.
So once I figured out that activists, they raise awareness, but entrepreneurs are really the ones that create solutions, I wanted to become an entrepreneur, and I started looking into entrepreneurship. I got familiar with Gary Vaynerchuk. I first wanted to start out actually as a fitness instructor, personal trainer, but I was like, that's really not me. So then I moved on and I moved towards life coaching. And that was also not really the thing, you know. I like to give advice for free to people, but I don't need to get charged for that because I think that's a given, the fact that you can do that. So then what was next? How can I run a business, have a product, sell a product, and actually make money? So I came up with Lilita. I started a non-profit organization called Lilita. I didn't officially register it yet, but it was in my mind. I made a whole video about it. You can check it down below. But the idea was to create kind of a social platform kind of store where all the products will wear the label of Lilita, which means they are proven to be ethical, vegan, fair trade, all these things, so consumers don't have to worry about it. An e-commerce store where other people can kind of do the dropshipping type of thing. Like, it was a bit vague because it was the early stages. But I started out Lilita, launched the video, got a lot of shares and a lot of feedback, a lot of people approaching me like, hey, I love this idea, I want to be a part of this. So within 10 days, I had 10 people, and in 30 days, I had over 30 people trying to help me out. But the thing is, with volunteers, even though I love every single one of them, it's a side thing. It's not something that they will focus on, it's not something that they can afford to focus on. So I was like, okay, I'm voluntary. Working with volunteers is not really my thing, but I do think that I can pull this off, but first I have to get capital.
So what was I good at? How can I get capital? That's basically the question. What skills can I use? What products can I sell or services can I do? And I figured that the best thing I can do, since I don't really have a physical product or the means to invest in physical products to buy, is to sell myself as a service, as a life coach, as a content creator, as a digital marketing strategist, as a business and a life strategist. Like, what angle did I find? And the hard thing about that was that I could try it out and I could try to find people, but I didn't have any credentials inside of this community of entrepreneurs or things like that. So I had to start from scratch. So what I did was I first started a little blog on a poker forum because I knew these people knew me, I had credentials over there, but I was out of the scene for a while and as expected, nothing really came from it. I also started to increase my vlogs, the amount of content I was putting out. And the cool thing about that is that the more content you put out, the more of a trail you leave behind and the more everything compounds. So let's say I do this daily vlog every single day. In 1 year, there's 365 videos people could watch from me. And if they think about working with me, they have a lot of content to actually look at. So through that, I started to get a few people who were interested in. My first paying client, actually, that's a really funny story, was Savannah Brooks. Savannah was a homeless girl. She only had 150 euro to her name and she transferred me without me asking her. I told her, don't pay. She still paid me the 100 euro and I kind of started to help her go through that journey. She became vegan and she improved a lot. She's now moving to a guest house of a vegan couple somewhere on the other side of the country, and all because she reached out to me and I accepted her and I helped her. Because what I did was, once I started coaching on the internet, I was trying to give away coaching for free, and this is way harder than it actually looks, because why would you want coaching from me? Only once, like, people are skeptical, only once you've proven yourself to be worth of value, then suddenly people want you, but then by that time, you're not gonna offer it for free anymore. So if you ever see somebody offering coaching for free and he's confident enough to offer that for free and you need some advice in that certain topic,
go for it. Like, you've got nothing to lose. You don't have to do what these people are telling you to do. But in the end, I had my first real client, small business owner. He didn't pay. He still didn't pay. He's ignoring me. And this is what I meant, that small business owners are nice to help, but they don't have the budgets to do some sustainable campaigns that will actually pay your bills. So I was trying to find the new angle, and then suddenly I discovered the vegan entrepreneur. I thought about the vegan entrepreneur, I don't know why, but it was still available, the domain name, the social media accounts, everything. And I was like, wow, this is what I really, really want to do. I don't mind working with small entrepreneurs, as long as they're vegan and I can help them move forward and create a better vegan world. Because in the end, that's what everything is about. But the thing is that even in this community, most people were just starting out and they didn't really have any budgets. So I kept looking, I kept pushing, I kept trying to develop myself and I kept trying to get new clients. I figured out a lot of ways. I contacted a lot of people by phone in the Netherlands who are vegan, who have an enterprise. And lucky for me, the Vegetarian Association came back to me and hired me for a job. Now, even though the Vegetarian Association hired me, this was really cool, but this wouldn't cover all my expenses yet. And lucky for me, I found Builderall. Builderall had an amazing opportunity with their white label, only I found out that it's quite hard to actually build trust and let people host their full business on something that is not known, that has no relevance, that has no credibility or anything. So we kind of kept going in circles. The vegan entrepreneur became a hobby where I provide valuable information to my community, and Builderall became a business opportunity. But then Builderall adjusted super quickly and they created a business in a box. They created the franchisee license, and that made me start out the Builderall U channel, because I figured a lot of people who are buying Builderall could be potential customers of mine. Plus, I think the mission that Eric, the owner of Builderall, or the CEO of Builderall, and Builderall and the whole team are working on is amazing. Plus, they're Brazilian and I lived in Brazil for 5 years, so I already had a direct link with that. I felt really close to Builderall, and I really love the idea where they're at right now and the opportunity that they're providing. Builderall itself, the tool, I think in 1 year from now, 2 years from now, this could compete with competitors like Wix and all the other big ones out there. So if I'm in there right now and I invest my time and effort to build up this community right now, we can do a lot of nice things. If I can become the authority on content marketing or inbound marketing in Builderall, this provides great, great opportunity. Within weeks after starting Builderall University, I got approached by multiple people who wanted to work together with me, and I finally found Tibor. Tibor is a Dutch guy who already has been running an agency for 8 years, and he's looking to expand, he's looking to scale and looking to grow and looking for somebody to join him in his business venture. He approached me, we talked, and within a week, we decided to become 50-50 partners, me creating content, helping build the community and do all these things, and he takes care of the back end, the client services and all these things. This is the perfect solution for me. So right now, this is where I'm focusing on, and Builderall U will be a channel where I will be providing a lot of valuable content, while the vegan entrepreneur will be a side hobby, and the vlogging channel is just a portfolio, building experience and putting myself out there with the same theory that compounding everything and making sure that you get more and more presence on the internet, it's always going to work for you. If I see the opportunities that came to me ever since I started on YouTube, I wished I would have done this the moment I started kitesurfing. The moment I started kitesurfing, documenting the journeys, the travels and all these things. So I regret not doing it then. I regret not doing it when I started playing poker. And now I'm definitely not gonna miss out a third time while I'm starting my journey as an entrepreneur. So, what did I learn from YouTube and what do I think you can get out of this? Well, number one is that your movies have to be entertaining. I love to ramble, I love to talk, but sometimes I just see that I can talk for 10-20 minutes, but the content might be valuable in my opinion, but it's not really enjoyable to watch. So learning how to tell the story better is something I enjoy and something that helped me along the way, because telling stories is what we do as marketeers. In this world today, where content marketing is so big, it's super important to tell the story rather than sell the product. And I'm getting better and better at this, and these YouTube videos are a fun way for me to experiment with new tactics, new ways, and it helps me to create better content. I just released a video for the vegetarian snack bar, and they had over 500,000 views within a week or so. So that was super cool, and it's as a direct result of me being active and learning and testing. Every single video I do, every single post I make on the internet, I learn from that. I see it as feedback, a way for me to see what people like and what people don't like. If you want to start a YouTube channel, if you thought about starting a podcast, a blog, or anything, then just go out and do it. There's nothing to be afraid of. It might feel scary in the beginning to put yourself out there that much, but trust me, in the beginning, nobody will read it anyway, and it really helped me finding my voice and figure out that I really want to be involved in content marketing, inbound marketing, and become an expert at community building and creating amazing videos. So this is one step of my journey in YouTube, and the things that I learned is that focus is the best. Consistency is what works. If you get people coming to your channel, your Instagram account, your Facebook page, whatever, be consistent and focus on one thing. Then once this rhythm goes and you actually get it consistently going in this exact ID. So for example, you open up an Instagram account and you only put inspirational quotes that mean something towards your goal. Then only post those. Don't post family pictures, don't post things around it. Open a second private account to do that. But be consistent with what you're doing. That's why The Vegan Entrepreneur is my vlogging channel. Builderall U is my educational channel. And then afterwards we're opening Builderall University, which will be a whole private way for me to coach people and help people grow in their business, in their lives, and achieve their goals. So my journey on YouTube, I have zero regrets. I'm looking forward to the next years to come, and I hope you're gonna be there with me on that journey. If you guys have any questions, just leave them down below and I will answer them as soon as possible. Thank you very much for watching this, and I hope you enjoyed this video. Bye.